The next most common local flap is a rotation flap, which we most commonly use for the scalp. Now, in the case of a rotation flap, again, our principle is the same. So whatever the shape of our defect, we are going to make it into an isosceles triangle. As explained in the transposition flap, why we choose an isosceles triangle. So in this case, our triangle, this is going to be the base of our triangle AB, and this is going to be the apex of our triangle C. Now what we need to remember in the rotation flap is that along this apex, that is C, we are going to extend an arbitrary line to get the base of our transposition flap. Now how much should this line be extended? Usually we consider this base AB and we make it 2.5 times AB to get this line. Now this line is going all along the line AC. It is an extension of that line. So suppose your base of the triangle is 2 cm, so that would make it 5 cm for the base of our flap, and we extend it up to that point. Now that end point is going to be D. Now from this point D, which is going to act as our pivot point, just like as explained in the transposition flap, this is going to be our pivot point. So from pivot point means we have our line of maximum tension, which would also go along the pivot point. Now from this point, we are going to start cutting an arc, which is going to start from point A. Once we take this arc, it is going to meet from this point. So actually beginning from this pivot point D, all along the way till the line of maximum tension, which is going along the base of our triangle, is going to be our rotation arc. Now this rotation arc is usually 5 to 7 times the base of our flap. So the base of the transposition flap is around 2.5 times the base of the triangle, and the arc of rotation is around 5.5 times the base of the triangle, which is 5.5 times AB. So this is what we take as a rule of thumb when we create this rotation flap. Now in this rotation flap, what we are going to see, that is our line of maximum tension along which is the movement of our flap. Now once this flap rotates, the final picture that we are going to get is going to be something like this. So this is how the flap is going to move and close into our defect, and ultimately we will have this extension around where it is closing. So this flap is going to move and close over here. So this is the type of movement we are going to have. Now by definition, a rotation flap has a primary closure. There is no secondary defect or an SSG that is required as in case of a transposition flap. The only other addition that you can make is that suppose you're not getting enough movement of the flap, you can do two things. Number one, you can either give it a back cut, or what you can do is you can make a Burrows triangle. Now a back cut essentially is given from a pivot point towards the base of the flap. Now the base of the flap is where you're getting your maximum blood supply, so you don't want to cut in too deep. You just give a little bit of extension so that your flap is going to move a bit more than what it originally did. Or in case you are planning a Burrows triangle, it actually comes on the outer side of your arc and not inside the rotation flap. So this is where you're going to cut out a Burrows triangle, and this much part is going to add to your flap. So this is how you can plan a rotation flap. So this would be the area of maximum laxity, so hence our flap is moving in this direction. If your flap moves from this direction, that means your laxity would be on that side. So depending on which side your laxity is, especially like we do in the case of a scalp, is where you would most commonly use a rotation flap.